Today we are going to study about sterilization and discussing that in a fermentation reaction. Most important thing is that we should have these five things. We should have a microbe which is producing required organism. We should have a media, a fermenter, additional nutrients and air if it is aerobic process. These are my five basic requirements for carrying out a fermentation or production process. Now let's talk about sterilization. What do I mean by sterilization? So sterilization, it is the process of killing, attenuating, inactivating all the undesired microbes which can interfere with the production of desired one. What do I mean by it? I mean is that I need to remove all the microbes which are initially present in the media, because you only want to have your particular choice of microbe for growing. So after making the media, having an optimum composition of carbon source, nitrogen source, oxygen, air and water, you need to go for the sterilization. And in sterilization, all the undesired microbes will be killed or inactivated. So why do we need to remove the contamination? We need to remove the contaminating microorganisms by sterilization because just a second, I need to disable the annotation. What can happen is that contamination by a foreign organism may result in contamination of the final product. It can lead to unnecessary consumption of our media to support the contaminating organism's growth. We want that media should only be supporting our own organism. It should not support the undesired organism's growth. Third thing is that it might happen that if you have not sterilized the media, the contaminated products will be overweighing the desired product. Fourth is the downstream processing or recovery of the product should be very easy. Once you are done with the production, there should not be any problem. But these contaminating products or side products, they may interfere with the recovery of the desired product. They will interfere with the downstream processing steps in the fermentation broth, and that we don't want. Apart from that, you are supplying the air to provide oxygen. If you have not sterilized your air, what will happen? Your fermentative product will get spoiled due to this unsterile air, because air is also holding a lot of undesired microbes. Okay, so this is a gist that for undesired, for optimum production, we need to sterilize a lot of things. This is a list of the things which we need to sterilize, as I have put in. Sterilization of the media, use pure and fresh inoculum, sterilization of the fermenter, sterilization of the pipes, walls, whatever is connected in the fermentation process, all the materials to be added. Sterilization of the air also that you are circulating. So not just the media, you need to sterilize the fermenter, the connected parts, air, and you need to disinfect even the contact parts. So to ensure the optimum production, we need to maintain the aseptic conditions in the broth. What is aseptic conditions? Aseptic conditions means, again, it is sterile conditions. Contamination ropes. So what are my methods of sterilization? In general, we use four methods of sterilization. One is by using heat from the steam, and a good example of this technique is autoclaving, whereby we use moist heat at temperature of 121 degrees centigrade and 15 psi to remove all the contaminating microorganisms. So sterilizing by using steam is the primary method that is used in the laboratories for sterilization. Second is I can go for using radiations from UV light. We all know that UV radiations have the capability to induce mutations. They cause thymine dimerization in the microbes, and due to this, the microbe gets unstable and they also get killed. So UV radiations are another source of sterilization. Third is we can use chemical disinfectants like ethylene dioxide, which are normally used in the fumigation in the hospitals. So chemical disinfectants are the third method, and last is filtration. The moment I talk about filtration, I am referring to the air sterilization. We'll come to it later on. Now, you know, we need to do the sterilization, but there are certain drawbacks when you are using heat at such a high temperature or when you are using the chemical methods. So what happens is that our media is having carbohydrates, proteins, essential ions. So if due to the presence of excessive carbohydrates, if you do the sterilization using heat, there could be a discoloration or browning or charring of the reducing sugars in the media, and this is known as Maillard browning reaction. Whenever you are trying to sterilize the carbohydrate components along with the protein components at high temperature, we observe one reaction known as Maillard browning, and this Maillard browning reaction causes entire media to be inactivated. So we don't want this. So whenever we have to do sterilization, because we need media to be totally sterile, but the carbohydrate component should be separately autoclaved. Otherwise, at a high temperature, it can do a Maillard browning reaction. So this is very important that this is a side effect. Now I'll come to the kinetics. How does this destruction of the microbes is happening at such a high temperature? So as we saw in case of growth, similarly in case of thermal death of microorganisms, it is first order kinetics. I want to show you my derivation. I'll go to that. I'll share one more PDF, not this one, to show you the reaction. Okay. So look at my screen. I've talked about if N naught is my initial number of the microorganisms in the system. So I want to kill all these microorganisms and get a sterilization whereby at the end of the process, I should have as minimum number of microbial growth in the media as possible, right? So just like growth, specific growth rate, I was telling you yesterday, which follows first order growth kinetics. In the same manner, you need to remember that thermal death kinetics, it is a first order reaction. So if I am subjecting my microbes, which are N naught initially in number, to heat, so with respect to time, this dN by dt, you can see I have used a negative sign here. Why I have used a negative sign? Because there is going to be a reduce in the number of microbes with respect to time. So that is what is our ultimate aim, that we want to sterilize, we want to kill these microbes. So time, this N number must decrease. So this derivation is showing me that it is first order kinetics. The rate of change of number of microbes with respect to time is equal to K into N. K is my thermal death constant and N is my normal number of microbes present in the media. So if I want to see the overall change whereby my initial count of microbes is changing from N naught to NT and time is changing from 0 to T. So I will do the integration. Do some reordering, shift this N on the left hand side and DT on the right hand side. So when you do the integration of 1 by N into DN with respect to the limit N naught to NT and the integration of DT with respect to time 0 to T. So what is the integration of 1 by N into DN? ln N. So this ln N comes on this side and this side I will use annotation so that you understand better. Okay, so this is the integration of 1 by N into DN ln N, and for T integration is simply T. So now you have to see the limits. Here the limits are N naught to NT, so it will become ln NT minus ln N naught, and on this side it is simply T minus 0 means T only. Now we will do some rearranging. You can also write whenever the two things are in this form, ln x minus ln y, we can write them as x upon y. This is a normal formula. So it becomes ln nt upon n naught is equal to minus kt. Minus sign was initially there because there is reduction in the count. So this equation is most important, that when we are talking about the death kinetics, the ultimate reaction is ln nt upon n naught is equal to minus K into T. So to remove the sign of negative, I can put N0 on the above side and NT on the lower side. If I reverse the reaction, the negative sign will be removed. Okay. I'll go further. So to remove the negative sign, I have shifted it upwards. To remove, initial reaction was NT upon N0 is equal to minus KT. To remove the sign of minus, I have shifted initial to the above side. So this factor ln N0 upon NT is known as del factor or inactivation factor. And what does this tells me? This tells me what is the fractional reduction in the number of microbes on a sterilization time T. So del factor is used as a measure of calculating the efficiency of this sterilization process. You need to remember this. The most crucial factor is del factor. And in quantitative terms, we define del as a ratio of logarithm of number of initial count of microbes and number of final count of microbes after sterilization. I hope it is clear. I'm again repeating the key points. Thermal death kinetics follows first order reaction. When you integrate, if you are assuming that total time for sterilization is T, initial count of microbes was N0, final count of microbes was NT, and the time limit has varied from the limit 0 to T. When you integrate, you get final equation as del factor, which is equal to ln N0 upon NT is equal to K into T. I'll come back to my PPT. Okay, so this was what I was referring in my derivation. So we have come to this. Yeh sign factor bahut important hai. Aksar bache sign mein gadbad karte hain. Agar NT upar hai aur N0 niche hai, toh minus sign will be there because it is showing that the count is decreasing. But if I make N0 on the above side, then it becomes ln N0 upon NT is equal to KT. So, ye aapko yaad rakhne ki zarurat hai ki kis time pe negative sign aayega aur kis time pe nahi aayega. So, the moment I reverse the reaction, it becomes this. So this factor, as I was telling you, that ln N0 upon NT is known as my inactivation factor or del factor. And the value of thermal death constant K here is entirely dependent on the type of cells and physiological form of the cells. I mean that if you are using a more sensitive strain, which is having high sensitivity towards heat, it will be killed easily. And if you're using physiological form, I mean, if you're using a fungus, then del factor will have a different value. If you are using a bacteria, del factor will have a different value. If you have an animal cell. So entirely the sterilization process and the thermal death kinetics is dependent on the type of the cells as well as the physiological form of the cells. So graphically, if I talk, whatever we are studying, we need to have clarity in terms of three things. What is the theoretical definition? What is the quantitative equation for that particular thing? And what is the graphical representation? For instance, in batch culture kinetics yesterday, when we were talking about the product profile, we discussed in three terms. What are the definitions of growth associated, mixed growth associated, and non-growth associated products? What is their respective equations? And what is their respective graph? Similarly, when I talk about the sterilization, we have just seen what is the first order reaction kinetics, what is the del factor. Now we should know what is the graphical representation. So I have shown here three microbes, A, B, and C. And my intention of showing this graph is two. That with respect to time, the on y-axis, I have taken number of microbes left after time T, and on x-axis, time. So when I plot a graph between ln n and time, you can see that with time there is decline in the number of microbes. So the curve is going downwards. And for different strains here, A, B and C are three different strains. Depending on their heat sensitivity, I have got different graphs. The strain which is having higher sensitivity towards temperature, they will be killed more easily and their time of sterilization is shorter. Now there is one more aspect when you are talking about the thermal death constant. As we are subjecting the microbes to high temperature for killing, so there must be some correlation, because if I had talked about the initial equation here, ln N0 upon NT, you can only see that there is a correlation between the number of microbes, time and death constant. But you did not get any relation here with respect to temperature. The question should have come in your mind कि ठीक है मैम आप बता रहे हो टाइम के साथ समझ में आ गया नंबर ऑफ माइक्रोब्स के टर्म में समझ में आ गया लेकिन वेयर इज द टेम्परेचर हियर हाउ डू आई कोरिलेट द टेम्परेचर विद स्टरलाइजेशन सो फॉर दैट एस्पेक्ट आई एम गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस अ नेक्स्ट टर्म विच इज हाउ टेम्परेचर इज रिलेटेड टू द डेड कॉन्स्टेंट सो दिस इक्वेशन हियर इज नोन एज आर्हेनियस इक्वेशन विच इज रिलेटेड टू माई death constant by following equation. Let me highlight it. So this is the equation that K is equal to A to the power E minus E upon RT. What is E here? E here is my activation energy for death, because you know similar the way microbes require activation energy for growing. Similarly, if the energy is going beyond that threshold, it becomes the activation energy for death. So in this equation, A here, capital A here is my Arrhenius constant. Small e here is my activation energy for death. R is my gas constant and T is my temperature. So by Arrhenius equation, I am able to relate the temperature with thermal death constant. Now let us see what happens to the original equation after putting these values. Okay. So I was knowing that ln N0 upon NT is equal to KT. And just now we learned that K is equal to AE minus E upon RT. I have again done a derivation. I will show you that how this is related. So look what happens when we put Arrhenius equation in correlation with the thermal death constant. So my ln is equal to, for my del factor is equal to ln N0 upon NT is equal to KT. And just now I learned that K is equal to AE minus E upon RT. So I will put this value in equation number one. So it becomes KT, may you have replaced K with the Arrhenius equation. So it becomes del is equal to AE minus E upon RT into time. Now I am able to correlate both the temperature and time with del. With the del is what? Del is my sterilization efficiency. It is telling the fractional reduction in the number of microbes after a sterilization time T. So I have put it here. Del is equal to AE minus E upon RT. Let me use the annotation so that it becomes clear. Okay. So this is my equation now, del related to temperature and time. Now I will take the logarithm on both the side, students. Shift this A on the left hand side and take the ln. So it becomes ln del upon A on this side. And here already the things were in exponential power, e to the power माइनस ई अपॉन आर टी. तो जब भी कोई चीज ऐसे होती है एक्सपोनेंशियल फॉर्म में, ठीक है ना, अगर मान लो ये ई टू पावर एक्स है और फिर जब मैं एल एन लूंगी इसका, तो इट बिकम्स ओनली एक्स. सो सेम थिंग आई हैव डन हियर. एंड व्हेन एवर वी आर हैविंग सम, मान लो आई हैव टू वेरिएबल्स एक्स इंटू वाई, ठीक है. सो इन टर्म्स ऑफ एल एन इट विल बी रिटन एज एल एन एक्स प्लस ln Y. And in the similar manner, suppose if I was having X minus Y, अगर ये ऐसा रहा होता instead of X into Y, so it will become ln X upon Y, ये division में चला जाता है, ठीक है? So here what I was having, since I had shifted A on left hand side, so it had become del upon A, and on the right hand side I was left only with this part, E minus E upon RT into time. So जब मैंने इसका ln लिया, तो क्योंकि ये e to power x का मैंने अभी भी आपको बताया, e to power x का अगर हम logarithm लेते हैं तो सिर्फ वो x रह जाता है, तो it has left only as minus E upon RT. And other factor was dot product was t, so it has become plus ln t. Now if I go downstairs, I can see that, let me remove first, that entire equation has become in a different form. So this is my final equation after rearranging on both the sides, and this equation is also known as design equation of sterilization, and we also call it as time temperature profile of sterilization. Okay, so ln t is equal to ln del upon A plus E upon R into 1 upon t. So by this equation, I am able to relate my sterilization time t with del factor. Del is my sterilization efficiency or fractional reduction in the number of microbes. A here is my Arrhenius constant. E here is activation energy for death. R here is universal gas constant, and T is my temperature. Now seeing this equation, if I want to plot a graph, how will I plot a graph between sterilization time and sterilization temperature? So you should see that this equation is like a straight line equation. What is the straight line equation? Y is equal to mx plus c, जहां पे आपका y और x वेरिएबल होता है, m हमारा स्लोप होता है और c हमारा इंटरसेप्ट होता है. सो दिस इक्वेशन इज सिमिलर टू दैट. टाइम इज माय वेरिएबल, लेट अस से इट इज 1, इट इज y नाउ. दिस ln del upon a, इट विल बिकम इंटरसेप्ट प्लस mx. सो e upon r इज माय स्लोप, एंड व्हाट इज 1 upon टेम्परेचर, इट इज x. So this equation, time temperature profile of sterilization or design equation, is similar to my straight line equation. Now easily I can plot a graph between ln t and 1 upon time. Let me plot it here. So when I plot a graph between sterilization time's logarithm and between reciprocal of temperature, I'll get a graph whose slope will give me the value of E upon R and the intercept, this value, students, the intercept of this graph, this will tell me the value of ln del, और Arrhenius constant तो हमारा पता है ना, constant है उसका value, तो आपको del से पता चल जाएगा. So I hope this is clear now that to find out the value of del, I can use design equation whereby the sterilization time and temperature are very important. You can note it down, then I will move ahead to the next concept. Okay, I'll remove it. Okay, let's move ahead. I can move everything from here. I'll share my PPT now. Okay. So this is what I just told you, design equation of sterilization. Same is there in my PPT. In the end, I am getting this equation. Lnt is equal to E by R 1 upon T plus Ln del upon A. So derivation was just covered. I will be nailing you that derivation, because in this slide, derivation is not there. And graph, just now I discussed that if I plot a graph between Ln of sterilization time and 1 upon temperature, the intercept is going to give me the value of del, and slope is going to give me the value of activation energy upon R. Now let's discuss an example. How do we calculate del factor? This question comes very frequently in the competitive examinations. कि हम del आखिर कैसे निकालेंगे? So del निकालने का तरीका ये है. आपको अभी भी मैंने बताया कि आपको हमेशा ये पता होगा कि initial count कितना है microbes का. So if I have taken example here, in a system the initial number of microbes present were 10^-3. And at the end of the process, it was known that unsterile culture contains final count as 10^11. Sorry, it was other way around. Initial culture had 10^11 and final culture after sterilization had value of 10^-3. So I just told you that del factor is ln n0 upon nt. So initial culture contained 10^11 microbes. After the sterilization, there is a fractional reduction in the count and the count becomes 10^-3. Simply put the values here of n0 and nt and you will get the value of del. So del here has come to 32.2. It's a very simple example. Whenever you will be given questions in the gate, you will be given either two things. Either you will be given in terms of the activation energy and temperature, or you will be given in terms of the initial number of microbes and final number of microbes after sterilization. This was just an example that how do we calculate del factor. Now let's talk about the overall process of autoclaving. That was a very simple method that if you are given N0 and NT, you can calculate del. What if you are given a process whereby it's an autoclaving reaction? So you should remember that what happens in autoclaving, the temperature is building initially from the room temperature to 121 degree centigrade. And then it is coming down from 121 to the normal temperature. जब आप उसको release करते हो pressure autoclaving में और उसको निकालते हो बाहर, then it is brought back to the normal temperature. So overall del, this is very important. That overall del is combination of del heating plus del holding plus del cooling. I will explain one by one. So del heating is the time when the temperature is building up from the room temperature to 121 degree centigrade. Please remember this, in this entire equation that I am discussing here, this is with reference to my autoclaving. I am going to write again on the screen. So what is my del heating? Del heating is when temperature is going till rising from initial to 121 degree. ठीक है, ये आपका del heating है. What is my del holding? You know that in autoclave we keep the media and things at 121 degree for 20 minutes. So that time is known as del holding. When you are keeping the media at 121 degrees for 20 minutes. तो उस समय जो आपका स्टरलाइजेशन होगा दैट इज नोन एज डेल होल्डिंग. एंड व्हाट इज डेल कूलिंग? डेल कूलिंग इज व्हेन टेम्परेचर इज कमिंग डाउन फ्रॉम 121 डिग्रीज बैक टू द नॉर्मल जब आप पूल कर रहे हो मीडिया को. सो टोटल थिंग हियर इज ओवरऑल डेल इज कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन दीज थ्री फेजेस. डेल हीटिंग when temperature is rising from initial to 121, plus del holding when you are keeping the media at 121, plus del cooling when the temperature is brought back from 121 to the normal. So you have to see ki kitna microbe kill ho raha hai in tino phases mein, and then you have to sum it up. Let's move on to the next slide. So just now I discussed that del is equal to kt. So overall del at different times is calculated as k1t, k2t, k3t. You should now think why I have used different values of thermal death constant, k1, k2, k3. क्योंकि अभी अभी हमने पढ़ा कि जो thermal death constant है वो temperature से related है और heating, holding और cooling time का temperature अलग अलग होगा. So that means अगर temperature अलग अलग होगा तो k का value भी अलग अलग होगा. सो अलग अलग पॉइंट पे डेल का कैलकुलेशन अलग अलग आएगा. सो टू कैलकुलेट द ओवरऑल डेल आई नीड टू कैलकुलेट के एट डिफरेंट पॉइंट्स यूजिंग डिफरेंट टेम्परेचर्स एंड आई हैव टू सम इट अप. सो ऑल द वैल्यूज एट डिफरेंट पॉइंट्स एंड दिस इज नोन एज ग्राफिकल मेथड ऑफ डेल कैलकुलेशन. आई कैन गिव यू अ टेम्परेचर एंड टाइम प्रोफाइल in a numerical. I can tell you that yes, let us suppose time is 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, 40 minutes. I'll just show you again by example what I'm saying here by graphical method. See, I can give you a table like this. जहां पे मैं आपको टेम्परेचर दे सकती हूँ और मैं आपको करस्पॉन्डिंग टाइम दे सकती हूँ स्टरलाइजेशन का. Time could be 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, 40 minutes. ठीक है. और यहां मैं ये बोल सकती हूँ कि 10 minutes पे time temperature था मेरा 100, 20 minutes पे मेरा temperature था 115, 30 मिनट्स पे मेरा टेम्परेचर था 121 और फिर उसको मैंने जब कूल करना शुरू किया तो टेम्परेचर हो गया 90. तो आपका अलग अलग टाइम पे अलग अलग टेम्परेचर है. एंड आई कैन आस्क यू नाउ टेल मी व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ डेल आफ्टर स्टरलाइजेशन. सो व्हाट यू विल डू करस्पॉन्डिंग टू टाइम 10 एंड टेम्परेचर 100 डिग्री यू नीड टू अप्लाई दिस इक्वेशन. डेल वन पता करना पड़ेगा. यहाँ पे चार वैल्यूज निकलेंगी डेल की. डेल वन मेरा कैसे निकलेगा? डेल वन मेरा निकलेगा आर्हेनियस कांस्टेंट का वैल्यू और आपको एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी भी दिया होगा एक ई माइनस एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी अपॉन यूनिवर्सल गैस कांस्टेंट मल्टीप्लाइड बाय टेम्परेचर इनटू स्टरलाइजेशन टाइम. सो यूजिंग दिस टाइम ऑफ 10 मिनट्स एंड टेम्परेचर ऑफ 100 यू कैन फाइंड आउट डेल वन. सिमिलरली फॉर डेल टू यू विल पुट टाइम एज 20 मिनट्स एंड टेम्परेचर इज 115. फॉर डेल थ्री यू विल पुट टाइम एज 30 मिनट्स टेम्परेचर इज 121. फॉर डेल फोर यू विल पुट टाइम एज 40 मिनट्स एंड करस्पॉन्डिंग टेम्परेचर एज 90 एंड यू नीड टू सम इट अप. So you will be getting overall del of the reaction. I hope you understood. These questions come very frequently in the gate examinations. Calculation of del in the sterilization. Let's move on to the next. But this is very, the question should come to your mind ki it's a very long method. I had just given you four values here. What if I give you 20 values? 20 values of time and 20 values of temperature, it will become very tedious. So to overcome this problem of graphical method of del, there was a scientist, Richard. He has given a Richard's rapid calculation method for estimation of del. I will show you that. There is another method for calculation of del, which is known as Richards rapid method. So before going to this method, you should know there are two assumptions of Richards method. When I was talking about autoclaving there, I said that we have to take into account all the three parameters: what is del heating, what is del holding, and what is del cooling. So Richard has given two assumptions. First assumption is that he said whatever destruction of the microbial spores or whatever destruction of the microbial cells is occurring, that is occurring only at a temperature of more than 100 degree centigrade. इसका मतलब ये है कि जब temperature मेरा buildup हो रहा था 37 मान लो room temperature था तो 37 से 121 तक जाता है autoclaving में. तो उसका कहना ये था Richard का कि जो किलिंग होगी, जो स्टरलाइजेशन होगा, दैट विल हैपन ओनली अबव 100. दैट मींस आई हैव टू ओनली टेक इनटू अकाउंट दोज वैल्यूज जब टेम्परेचर बिल्डअप हो रहा है 100 से 121 हीटिंग फेज में, जब वो 100 के ऊपर जा रहा है, क्योंकि थर्मल डिस्ट्रक्शन जो है वो 100 के ऊपर ही होता है, उसके नीचे नहीं होता है. सिमिलरली ही सेड दैट फॉर द कूलिंग ऑल्सो, वेन द टेम्परेचर इज कमिंग डाउन, when you are cooling the media after sterilization, after autoclaving, when the temperature is coming down from 121 to 37, again the death of microbes, thermal death is occurring only in the range of 121 to 100. 100 ke niche nahi hoga. So you can ignore the calculations when the temperature is changing from 37 to 100. You have to take only those values whereby the temperature is more than 100. I hope it is clear. So that was the first assumption. And second assumption of Richards method was that cooling and heating cycles are linear. What do I mean by this? That cooling and heating cycles are linear. He said that for every 1 degree change in the temperature, it is taking 1 minute, and the value of del at time t plus 1 is dependent on value of del at time t. कहने का मतलब ये है, अगर मैं यहाँ पे बात कर रही हूँ कि टेम्परेचर 100 से 121 जा रहा है, तो 21 डिग्रीज का ही चेंज हुआ. 21 डिग्रीज के लिए ही सेड दैट कूलिंग एंड हीटिंग साइकिल्स आर लीनियर. दैट मींस एक मिनट, एक डिग्री चेंज के लिए एक मिनट का टाइम लगेगा. तो इसका मतलब ये 100 से 121 जाने में कितना डिग्रीज है? 21 डिग्रीज. तो टाइम कितना लगना चाहिए? 21 मिनट्स. So his ideal assumption was that it should take 21 minutes to have a temperature change of 21 degree, because the assumption says that it is linear. And second point which was I was stressing here was that the thermal destruction at time t plus 1 is dependent on the value of thermal destruction at time t. So agar mujhe ye check karna hai ki 16th minute pe del ka value kya hai, तो उसने ये बोला कि प्रीवियस वैल्यू पे डिपेंड करता है. यानी 16th मिनट का जो डेल है वो इस वैल्यू पे डिपेंड करता है कि 15th मिनट पे डेल का वैल्यू क्या था, एक मिनट पहले डेल का वैल्यू क्या था. सो लीनियर हियर मींस दिस ओनली, दैट यू विल कंसीडर दैट फॉर 1 degree चेंज इन टेम्परेचर द टाइम टेकन इज 1 मिनट एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ डेल एट टाइम टी प्लस 1 इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन द वैल्यू जस्ट 1 मिनट बिफोर. What was the del value at time t? Let us show it by means of the equation. So this is what I was saying. He said that del factor at 100 will be neglected and only above 100 it will be calculated. So del at other temperatures is dependent on the previous temperature which occurred 1 minute earlier. So I can write it in terms of formula that del at temperature T is equal to what is the value of del 1 minute before. मैं 16th और 15th minute का example देके आपसे बात कर रही थी कि अगर मुझे ये देखना है कि del का value 16th minute पे और 101 temperature पे कितना है, तो वो depend करेगा कि del का value उससे 1 degree कम temperature पे कितना था. और मैं ये मान के चल रही हूँ कि 1 degree change के लिए 1 minute का time लगता है. तो ये स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्मूला है कि डेल टी, डेल एट एनी टाइम टी इज इक्वल टू del at T minus 1 plus value of K at time temperature T into 1. इससे आपका बहुत इजी हो जाता है कैलकुलेशन. आई विल शो यू हाउ. सो दिस इज अ एग्जांपल रिचर्ड हैड गिवन. केटी मान के चला है इसने, डेल इज इक्वल टू केटी और के का वैल्यू था 9.6 और उसने ये माना था कि आइडियल टाइम जो है वो 21 मिनट लगना चाहिए क्योंकि हीटिंग और कूलिंग साइकिल्स लीनियर है. बट ही गेव अ एग्जांपल, ये हीटिंग और कूलिंग जो आपको दिख रहा है, ही गेव अ एग्जांपल कि एक ऐसा प्रोसेस है जहां पे हीटिंग में टाइम लगा है 25 मिनट, 100 से 121 जाने में टाइम लगा है 21 मिनट्स. आई विल राइट ऑन द स्क्रीन सो दैट इट इज क्लियर टू यू. जो पहला अजम्पशन था रिचर्ड का वो ये था कि 100 डिग्री के ऊपर ही हम कंसिडर करेंगे. तो इस एग्जांपल में क्या हुआ है, 100 से 121 जो कि हीटिंग टाइम था उसको जाने में टाइम लगा है 25 minutes. और फिर होल्डिंग आ गया था. होल्डिंग हमारा क्या होता है, डेल होल्डिंग वो होता है कि 121 पे क्या वैल्यू होगी. और कूलिंग में उसने बोला है कि 121 से फिर नीचे आने में, जब हम मीडिया कूल करना शुरू करते हैं, 121 से 100 आने में हमको टाइम लगा है कूलिंग फेज में 15 मिनट्स का. अब आइडियली रिचर्ड के हिसाब से क्योंकि साइकिल लीनियर है तो 100 से 121 जाने में 21 मिनट का टाइम लगना चाहिए था. और सिमिलरली 121 से 100 आने में वापस कूलिंग फेज में 15 मिनट लगना चाहिए था. लेकिन यहाँ पे टाइम अलग अलग है. एंड दिस सो डेल माय नॉर्मल डेल इज के इनटू टाइम. ठीक है, तो अगर 21 मिनट से अलग टाइम लगता है क्योंकि वो तो लगेगा ही नॉर्मल रिएक्शन में, तो यहां पे k का वैल्यू, इफ k वाज गिवन टू यू एज 9.601 एंड यू वर गिवन दैट टाइम टेकन इज 25 मिनट्स इन बिल्डिंग फ्रॉम 100 टू 121, एवरी केस यू विल डिवाइड बाय 21 क्योंकि लीनियर का अजम्पशन है. तो टाइम, एक्चुअल टाइम निकालने के लिए आपको फ्रैक्शन लेना पड़ेगा. सो डेल हीटिंग हियर इज कैलकुलेटेड एज k का वैल्यू वाज 9.6 इनटू 25 मिनट्स टेकन टू बिल्ड द टेम्परेचर अपॉन 21 जो कि लीनियर अजम्पशन के हिसाब से था. सिमिलरली फॉर द कूलिंग पीरियड अगेन डेल इज इक्वल टू केटी, के का वैल्यू इज 9.6, टाइम जो मेरा लगा है वो 15 मिनट लगा है कूल होने में और रिचर्ड के अजम्पशन के हिसाब से 21 मिनट लगना चाहिए लीनियर साइकिल में. तो जब भी मुझे, आपको सिंपल कैलकुलेशन होगा, अगर टाइम टेम्परेचर प्रोफाइल दे रखा है तो आपको डेल हीटिंग, होल्डिंग और कूलिंग निकालना पड़ेगा. ठीक है, एंड डेल होल्डिंग यू कैन इजिली फाइंड. डेल होल्डिंग हाउ डू आई फाइंड आउट, अगेन आई विल यूज के इनटू टी, टाइम जो भी जिस मोमेंट पे भी हुआ होगा और टेम्परेचर आप लोगे 121. तो आपको सिंपली तीन चीजें पता होनी चाहिए इस मेथड के हिसाब से कि 100 डिग्री के ऊपर जाने में, 121 तक जाने में कितना टाइम लग रहा है और के का वैल्यू क्या है. सो सिंपली बाय दिस फॉर्मूला यूजिंग द इक्वेशन दैट डेल हीटिंग एंड डेल कूलिंग इज इक्वल टू के इंटू जो भी टाइम मेरा लग रहा है बिल्डअप होने में अपॉन 21. हर बार आपको अपॉन 21 करना है क्योंकि लीनियर का अजम्पशन है. इसी तरह कूलिंग में भी, और आप फिर उनको ऐड कर दोगे तीनों को, डेल हीटिंग प्लस डेल होल्डिंग प्लस डेल कूलिंग एंड यू विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ डेल. तो दो तरीके थे डेल कैलकुलेशन के, एक ग्राफिकल मेथड था जो मैंने आपको दिखाया जो कि बहुत लंबा मेथड था जिसमें हमें हर पॉइंट पे डेल पता करना पड़ रहा था, डेल 1, डेल 2, डेल 3, डेल 4 और उसके बाद हम सबको ऐड करते. और एक रिचर्ड्स का शॉर्ट मेथड है जिसमें 100 के नीचे की कैलकुलेशन हमको इग्नोर करनी है और हमको ये मानना है कि साइकिल्स लीनियर हैं, 21 मिनट्स लगेगा और हीटिंग, होल्डिंग और कूलिंग ऐड करके हम पता कर लेंगे. दिस मेथड वाज वेरी टेडियस, द वन आई डिस्कस्ड ग्राफिकल, एंड टू ओवरकम दिस वी हैव कम विद द रिचर्ड्स शॉर्ट मेथड एंड फास्ट मेथड. आई होप इट्स क्लियर. So I'll go to the, in brief, I will tell you, because Abhinav sir will discuss in detail in his lectures, that what are the, just like culture methods, they can be batch, fed batch and continuous. The methods of sterilization can also be divided into two broad categories, batch sterilization and continuous sterilization. What is batch sterilization? Batch sterilization is a process in which all the contents, the media, whatever you want to do, all the contents are loaded into the sterilization and steam is injected to see that yes, sterilization happens as per the program time, and later the contents are discharged or transferred directly into the fermenter. So it's not a continuous process, it's one time process. Take the sterilizer, feed all your nutrients, what you want to sterilize, and after the processing time of sterilization, you need to take out. So autoclaving is an example of batch sterilization. You load all your vessels, all your glassware, media, everything in the autoclave, put it for a time of 121 and 20 minutes, and then you take out. Jab tak wo 15 psi pe aur 121 degree pe aa jata hai, and at the end of the process, you take out. So that's a batch sterilization process. It's not a continuous. So advantages of batch sterilization is that initial cost of investment is very low and the chances of contamination after the sterilization is done. Ek batch ke baad jo sterilization ke chances hai, wo kam ho jate hain. Aur teesra ye hai ki isme manual control easily lag jata hai. To mechanical failure ke chances nahi hai batch sterilization mein. Lekin drawback bahut saare hai iske. So to overcome this, we came with continuous sterilization process. In batch, you were doing it just one time. And in continuous, you are doing it regularly. The sterilizer is attached to the fermenter and regularly the media, air, everything is getting sterilized. So the capacity of continuous sterilization is much higher. The media quality can be maintained in a better way. This process does not require manual control. It has automatic control. And the cost of running here is lesser. The sterilization time is shorter in case of continuous sterilization. And you should remember that for high temperature and short time treatment, this is the best option. Many a times you want to subject your media to more than 150 degree. In that case, if you want to have that tough kind of the sterilization, then it is a good option, continuous sterilization. And holding capacity is also low. And ease of scale up. You can easily scale up the continuous sterilization process from batch, from lab scale to industrial scale. Iska problem lekin ye hai, disadvantage ye hai ki iska initial cost of investment is very high and you require to have a aseptic transportation along the line. Whenever you are doing, you need to make sure that continuously aseptic transportation is maintained of the sterilized components. And we use two equipments. I hope Abhinav sir will cover in detail. I'm just giving you a gist that for the continuous sterilization, we use two equipments in the lab. One is continuous plate heat exchanger and second is continuous injection and flash cooling. So I think sir will be explaining this in detail. In continuous plate heat exchange, you can see in the figure, we are in first cycle, we are giving the raw media. That raw media is going into the heat exchanger and getting sterilized from the previous batch of the media. So usme preheating hoti hai ek bari media ki. Phir do bari heat hone ke baad, let me use the annotation. Ye step number one hai mera. Ye raw media mera ja raha hai sterilizer mein. Aur ye jo aapko ye wali upar ki arrow dikh rahi hai, this is showing that your initial media is getting preheated from the sterile media outgoing. So you are feeding in the sterilizer, the raw media, which is going to be preheated by the sterile media of the first round. In second exchanger, I'm giving steam to heat the media. So two types of preheating was there. First preheating with the sterile media of the raw media, and second was with the steam. After doing the preheating in two phases, I will put my media in the holding section, where it will be at temperature of 121. From holding section, it will get thoroughly sterilized and then it will again go to the cooling section. Lekin cooling mein jane ke pehle aapko ye arrow dikh raha hoga, ye direction. Cooling mein jane ke pehle ye preheat karega next batch ko. Kyunki aisa nahi hai ki sirf ek bari heating hogi. Continuous process hai. So regularly the fresh batch is going to be sterilized from the previous batch. So preheating is going to be there, and after preheating the initial batch, it is going to the cooling water, cooling section. It is getting cooled by the cooling water, and finally in the outcome you are getting your sterile media. So this was my step number one. जहां पे मैंने पहला लॉट रॉ मीडियम का डाला और वो प्री हीट हुआ. सेकेंड वॉज माई दिस स्टेप वेयर द स्टीम हैज प्री हीटेड द मीडिया. थर्ड वॉज माई होल्डिंग सेक्शन. फ्रॉम होल्डिंग इट इज गोइंग आउट. एंड फोर्थ वॉज माई कूलिंग सेक्शन. सो यू नीड टू रिमेंबर इन दिस फिगर द स्टेप्स 1, 2, 3, 4. टू राउंड ऑफ प्री हीटिंग फॉलोड बाय होल्डिंग एंड देन कूलिंग. There is one more equipment which is used apart from continuous plate heat exchanger. This is known as continuous steam injection and flash cooling. For two equipments I discussed now, that we use two equipments for continuous sterilization. One is my continuous plate heat exchanger and second is my continuous steam injection and flash cooling. So in second one there is no preheating. I'll show you the steps here. This is my raw media. It is going in the first section where the steam is provided for a little bit heating, and directly it is going to the holding section. So yahan pe jo utna lamba prolonged preheating time tha continuous heat exchanger mein, waisa nahi hota hai. Here we begin directly from the holding section. It goes through the holding section for heating up and for sterilization, and then it goes to the flash cooler so that no time is wasted in cooling. We subject the media under vacuum to the flash cooling so that it happens in very less time. So in continuous steam injection and flash cooling, we are going to subject the raw media to the holding section at a high temperature of 121, and immediately we are after the holding section, the media is going to be put in the flash cooler under vacuum so that it is instantly cooled. So time taken here for the whole process is very, very less. Abhinav sir will be talking in detail about these in his section, types of sterilization. So I won't be going much in the detail. And last is air sterilization. Air sterilization, we again, like normal sterilization, we can do by heating. We can do by using UV rays, germicidal sprays, or by filtration. Filtration, we will use two kind of the filters to trap airborne microbes. One type of filter is known as fibrous filter, and other type of filter is known as absolute filter. I have shown you the comparison here. Absolute air filters are those filters whose pore size is very small as compared to the particle size of the microbe, and sterilization efficiency is 100% for absolute air filters. So what you do is that HEPA filters in the laminar airflow, which you use, they are the example of absolute air filters. So then when the microbe is passing through these filters, as the size of the filter is lesser than the microbial size, microbe cannot pass the filter and it gets entrapped. So absolute air filters are best, but the problem is that choking and clogging takes place very fast in absolute air filters, and cleaning and replacement is costly and it's difficult. On the contrary, fibrous type of filters are the one in which they are made of wool, cotton, all these kind of material. Fibrous air filters are the one in which the gap between the material is higher than the particle size. Here the sterilization efficiency cannot be 100%, but the thing is that their initial cost of investment is low, clogging and choking does not take place, and cleaning and replacement is easy. This is what I have told you here, that we have two filters, absolute and fibrous. Absolute filters give us 100% efficiency of sterilization. Their pore size is smaller, and fibrous filters are made up of cotton, glass wool, slag, steel, and their pore size is bigger than the size of the microbes. And how do they entrap the microbes? They entrap by means of diffusion, by means of impaction, by means of gravitation, or by electrostatic force. So this comparison you need to study that yes, in terms of cost, fibrous filters are cheap, but in terms of efficiency, absolute filters are better. And one last parameter is X90. When you are designing these air filters, you must know what is the value of X90. X90 is actually, when you're designing, it tells us that what should be the depth of air filter in designing that is required to entrap 90% of the microbes and ensure that efficiency of sterilization is 90% for the air sterilization. So X90 is a parameter for designing the air filters. It ensures that depth of the filter that will entrap 90% of the microbes and give us efficiency of 90%. So thank you all. I hope you were able to understand the first order kinetics, del factor calculation, design equation of sterilization, and the calculations.